Hello, dissenters. My name is Etalyx, and I am here today in the blood-soaked, snowy battlefields of Running with Rifles, a game we haven't talked about in some time. But we have talked about it a couple times in the past. Most recently, almost 2 years ago or something insane like that. This is a tactical, military, but arcadey shooter altogether. That's a grenade. I just threw a grenade on top of that rock, luckily injuring no one in the process. Doesn't matter though, got airstriked. Gotta be careful in this game, but sometimes there's nothing you can do about it. Respawning close by, you'll see what our primary objective is. We're playing in the campaign right now in single player. The campaign, honestly, the objectives are whatever you make of them. We're trying to capture the South Trench. That's what all of the NPCs are doing right now. But if we wanted, we could take a sneak attack to the North Trench, which is still being guarded, but it's possible. It's possible. Gives you some open-ended objectives to take on, and as you complete each mission, you kind of get a little bit of a choice as to where you want to go next. But it doesn't stop there at the single player. You can actually take it online and play either completely PvP, where all these dudes could be other players, or PvE, where you can take on, with some friends, these style missions. Which I think is pretty awesome. Also, we got some people doing some flanking maneuvers on us. Here in the back, I think we're about to run out of ammo and need to reload, so we're probably gonna do that and help follow up our friendly troops here. Around the side, I usually like to ooh, yeah, that's a little scary. Anytime we see the brown pants, we gotta run the other direction. So we're the green guys, and we're fighting against the brown pants. All right, so that's how you know who's a good guy and who's a bad guy. We've got a heavy machine gun right now that we have to be lying prone or have some kind of surface to support us in order to fire it. And we're hiding out in this trench right now, which we're not gonna be hiding for very long, unfortunately, because we're gonna get grenaded, so I probably shouldn't run in there by myself. But that being said, we're trying to stack as many people into that southern trench as we can, and you'll watch this bar at the bottom right of the screen start filling up to whatever color is controlling it. And of course, in future campaign missions, you might be fighting more than one faction. It's not just the green pants versus the brown pants. There's also some gray pants in there, and they each kind of represent different military factions. Like, we're kind of the stereotyped American forces. I think the brown pants are like the Russians, and the grays are probably like Chinese or something. I have no idea. This is ripe for the... I feel like I'm gonna die if I get any closer, but I really want to throw a grenade. Grenade out! Take cover! I got at least one or two and blew up the box cover that they were using also. Let's try sneaking prone over to this side and see if we can shoot over this barrier into the midst of them. So we've got like realistic line of sight as well, it's worth noting. So anytime you see like that little gray line pointing towards my cross area, it means you can't shoot there. See what I'm saying? So if I crawl up to the edge, you can see that gray line kind of disappear. We're able to shoot over the edge. I gotta reload, so let's hope that that goes quicker. Then we can start opening fire again, taking out as many of these guys as possible. The one or two complaints I have about the game so far that I would like to see tweaked, they are easy tweaks though, thankfully. One is, it's easy to lose track of your own bullets. I'm not a big fan of the darker bullets color. I like having the kind of yellow streaks. So if I keep firing, you can faintly see those little shadowy bullet markers going across the screen. It's not really distinctive enough for me. I get confused as to if I'm still shooting or not, whether I'm still reloading. I would love if they made your own players sound effects, shooting, reloading, all that stuff, louder than everyone else's. That would go a long way towards making this a lot more tactile. So we're just mowing down as many enemy forces as we can, trying to give our guys cover fire. We've killed at least two or three right now, and for a better explanation of why, we're not just killing people in order to capture this base. We're also killing people in order to level up. So each time I get kills, we're gaining experience. Let's see if I can actually get a kill. Maybe do a better job of explaining that experience system. Did I just get pushed all the way back from my cover by my friendly unit? I think I did. I feel like I'm in a really bad spot, but so far they haven't been able to kill me. They are really, really flanking. Okay, plus 4 XP, plus 4 XP. The more kills you get, in fact, the more experience you start to accrue. So we got a nice combo on the right-hand side before we got killed and went down. So we're going to push space, and here we'll be able to see our experience totals. We got 1,231 total. The more experience you get, the higher ranking you achieve. See how that guy just said, let's go? He is probably commanding some troops. Look at his ranking, 4,300. He's a staff sergeant. So the higher ranking you get by grinding enemies, the more troops you'll be able to command. Let's in fact see if we can command one such troop now and maybe even find a vehicle along the way. I think there's a Jeep up here we might be able to use if it doesn't get blown up or commandeered. Let's go ahead and take that now. I know that guy was going for it. Let's back up. There's an enemy APC close by. Vehicles are a factor here. This is a great way to transport troops from one side of the battlefield to the other, of course, provided you have the necessary squad in order to achieve that. And APCs are going to give you a lot more armored protection and the ability to shoot from cover. Of course, there are counters. There are rocket launchers and probably C4 and all that stuff. Speaking of which, I'm going to go ahead and head on into our base. I see the armory truck is close by. This guy's joining the squad because with our 1,000-plus experience, we're a corporal, which means we get one troop to our name. So like I said, the more we grind, the higher level we get, the more the troops respect us. It's a very, very cool system. So at the beginning of the game, you start out as just another private. You can follow another higher-ranking officer if you want to, maybe join their squad. Let's hold F here to see the armory and give you a little preview of the depth of the game from an equipment standpoint. So you have shotguns, you've got MP5, sniper rifles. I have the M240 right now, but you start with the default M16. So as you do things in the game, you get RP. So that's going to allow you to purchase other gear. So if I wanted deployable cover, I could take that and throw it in my backpack for a small fee. And as we level up, once I get 1,500 experience, I can get a machine gun to deploy or a mortar, which that sounds like it's going to be really helpful. But you gotta level up first to be able to use these cool things. I have commandeered the Jeep, which is kind of a funny situation. If you are of a lower rank than someone in the Jeep, they'll say, just buzz off. Like, you're not going to take this Jeep. This is my Jeep. I resent that you try to take it from me. What we're going to do now is actually go on a secret stealthy mission. As I'm bouncing into literally everything nearby. Let's see how we're doing. Maybe the North Trench? Maybe we could sneak around to the West Camp? I don't even know if that's doable. Let's try it out. These guys have their work cut out for them here in the South Trench. Battles in the campaign can actually take hours if you're not careful. Woo-hoo-hoo-hoo! Those rockets are getting close! And yes, we can be sniped out of this Jeep so easily, I'm going to try to avoid combat, but it's awesome that our teammate can actually shoot out of the passenger side. That is insane. Where are we right now? I think, oh, that's pretty heavily enforced over here. I don't think that just the two of us can handle this. But this is the sandbox nature that I was talking about. You can just embark on your own quests, maybe even get yourself a silenced pistol and do some infiltration. Overall, I have been having a blast here in Running with Rifles. The gameplay can get repetitive, though. Please know that, especially when it can literally take hours fighting over one single location like the Southern Trench. But it's lovely having the campaigns accessible to you and being able to fight in a whole different variety of battlefields. It's not all snowy trenches. There's like 6 or 7 different biome types, I guess you could call it. There's a day-night cycle, so you can actually get a little visual representation of how long you've been fighting. Also, the blood-soaked soil everywhere, that did not begin that way. That's just indicative of how many troops have died in this location. So it has an epic scope, I would say. And the online functionality is really cool, too. The ability to play co-op with your friends, for example. And stop pushing me around, guys. Please, just leave me alone. This is important, all right? The ability to take them on in co-op is really cool. What are you doing way over here? I just got sniped. Hang on. I got a rocket launcher. What have I been doing this whole time? I don't think we can hit him. We're gonna have to chase him down. We're gonna have to chase this guy down. Okay, fire. OMG rocket. I love the little text bubbles that they have along the way too. It's just so cute. Follow me. Yes, sir. Scott Campbell, sir. There is one more thing I can think of to show you guys. And that is the ability to give commands through the radio by leveling up. So with enough experience, you unlock radio commands. You also have to get RP as well by killing enemies and completing objectives. And with that RP, you can call in mortar strikes, reinforcements, artillery, combat transportation, sounds awesome, or APCs. That's really cool. And it just gives you some long-term goals to try to take on for yourself. So If I kept playing and kept accruing RP, I could start calling in some mortar strikes, start assisting my troops in various ways. Also, with your crew, like this guy, Melvin Ortiz, I can order my crew around. So I want him to go over there. I can right-click and tell my squad to move there. Or I can right-click myself and tell him to regroup and follow me. Lots and lots of really cool strategic tactical options when playing. But there is definitely a huge grind at the beginning of the game. Primarily just because you have to accrue enough experience in order to have a squad of your own. Anyways, guys, hope you enjoyed this little video on running with rifles. Maybe give it a try yourself. I think it's a really solid game, and I'm glad to see that it's finally out of development. That is probably the most exciting thing. That's a grenade. Just gonna duck crawl away out of here. Thank you guys so much for watching this video. I appreciate it very much. If you enjoyed it, please leave a like on any videos that you might enjoy. My name is Etalyx, and I hope to see you soon.